Let's move on and talk about Bitcoin, the cryptocurrency actually bouncing a little bit higher today. Jim says there's an even bigger rally ahead. Jim, you've been saying that for some time now. What's the trade?
I haven't been wrong. I haven't been wrong yet, by the way. Very stable lately. So we have a trade still alive from last week that's a bullish trade that's right around where the entrance was. So I think actually if the June Bitcoin trades 7775, 7,775, to me that's another one of these stop-in levels with a target of 8,500. Stop placed below 7,275. The thing that I just mentioned about the lack of volatility in Bitcoin from a comparative basis, that's not a neutral thing. That's very Bitcoin positive. If these futures contracts that were launched, however, what was it, 6 months ago, if they're creating stability in the price could draw in some new participants, some new investors, if you want to call someone who buys Bitcoin an investor, and that's probably something that's price positive. I don't love Bitcoin. I think in 5 years, we might not even remember what Bitcoin was. I'm not saying that's for sure, but it's certainly a possibility. But I think from a price standpoint, it looks like it could pop a little higher.
All right, he brings up a good point, Brian. Even if you hate Bitcoin, this fact that we are seeing stability, I don't know, it makes me think Jim's on to something.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a huge thing that we're seeing stability, and I think what we're seeing is Bitcoin starting to evolve itself, meaning that it is starting to be an anti-fiat currency, anything but the dollar. So it's tied to the dollar. It's also tied to volatility in the market, and it's pricing basically credit risk. If you want to take your money off your bank balance sheet and put it somewhere else, Bitcoin is allowing that avenue. It's a much easier transactional cost basis than moving it into a gold bar or something like that. And so I disagree with Yuri. It's going to go away 5 years from now. I think it's very real. It's a measure of volatility. It's a measure of the U.S. dollar. And I think when we talk about the strength in the dollar, starting to strengthen here, even though it's sold off over, obviously, over the last month. But down the road, if we're going to get some strength in the dollar, I think you're going to get strength in Bitcoin. And I think that's going to make sense for Bitcoin.
I think I said it might be going to 5 years. And the reason I say that is that I don't necessarily believe that it's the best cryptocurrency out there. I think it had the nice spot of being the first one that gained velocity and steam. And I think that there's others that might have characteristics. But I think that cryptocurrencies will be here. And Bitcoin may be here, too. I don't know if I'm on an island with this last theory, but I have a feeling that there are law enforcement agencies around the world who might want to fund black ops in Bitcoin and might like the fact that it keeps some value. I've never heard anybody else say that. You might think I'm crazy, but this is... Okay, well, now you have. So I think that there might be some people who care about it. Okay, go on.
All right, well, let's get the risk reward on this trade. We'll end on that note there. Jim is buying CBOE Bitcoin futures, 7,775, targeting a move up to 8,500. Each point is also worth 7,775. So he's risking 500 to make 725 on this trade.